Hello students, in the last two lectures we had discussed about sequences of complex numbers Zn, of which members are complex constants like Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4 and so on. And correspondingly we have discussed series of complex numbers of which terms are Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 plus Z4 and so on. Today we will discuss sequence of complex functions which is denoted by this Fn, F suffix n, in bracket, Z variable. So n variable runs over natural number and Z variable in the complex plane. So we will decide how to decide the members of the sequence varying n. So first member of this fnz sequence will be f1z, second member will be f2z, third member will be f3z and so on, and correspondingly sequence series will get f1z plus f2z plus f3z and so on. Just I'd like to cite an example. Sequence z to the power n, z to the power n. So that sequence members will be, first member will be z to the power 1, z to the power 2, comma z to the power 3, comma z to the power 4 and so on. And corresponding series of that sequence will be z to the power 1 plus z to the power 2 plus z to the power 3 plus z to the power 4 and so on. This is called series of complex functions, of which convergence and or divergence we will discuss at a particular point z equals to z naught on the complex plane or in some domain in the complex plane. So let us take a specific example of function. Sequence of functions an into z minus b whole to the power n, where b is a fixed point on the complex plane. In the complex plane, b you can consider as z naught, like z minus z naught whole to the power n. So just I have cited the example, as I cited the example of z to the power n, instead of z to the power n you can think of z minus b whole to the power n. So this is a sequence which is consisting of z variable and n, over which sequence members will run, and an is also a complex number, complex sequence, of which members are a1, a2, a3, a4 and so on. So here is a constant, a sequence of complex numbers, and this is sequence of complex functions. Product of those is denoted by fnz. So this series a0 plus an, series n equals to 1 to infinity an z minus b whole to the power n, a0 is added, extra added. You can say that since it is told that an is a sequence of complex numbers, so how can it be possible that n equals to 0? You can think like this, that a0 is the first term of the series and the second term of the series is corresponding to n equals to 1, a1 into z minus b whole to the power 1, and third term will be a2 into z minus b whole to the power 2 and so on. And briefly we can denote this series by this, starting from n equals to 0 to infinity in brief form. Again I am saying n equals to 0 is not corresponding to natural number, because 0 is not a natural number. So n equals to 1 to infinity is represented this sequence and correspondingly series. A naught is the first term just added with this series. Is called a power series in z minus b. So if z minus b hold to the power n, if we see, it will be called z minus b power series. Power series in z minus b. We need not to mention this an. An are the coefficients of power series in z minus b, like polynomial. Polynomial has coefficients. If f of x, real valued function, is a polynomial, like a naught plus a1x plus a2x square plus and so on, an x to the power n. So it can be written as summation n equals to 0 to I equals to 0 to n ai x to the power I. So it is ai in that case are the coefficients, represent the coefficients of the function f of x. So similarly, here for the power series, coefficients will be an and power series in z minus b. And when z b equals to 0, this point is 0, simply this form is taken of the power series in z. Then an theorem, simple theorem, power series in z converges at a particular point z naught in the complex plane, represents, means or implies, this power series in z converges absolutely for this region or this open circular disk. What is this modulus z equals to z naught? If it is modulus z equals to modulus z naught, suppose modulus z naught is representing a point on the complex plane 3 plus 4i. Then modulus z naught, what it will be? Modulus z naught or modulus 3 plus 4i equals to 5. So mod z equals to modulus z naught equals to 5 represents a circle surrounding the origin centered at the origin of radius 5. So what is this representing? So inside the circle, that is an open circular disk, this is representing an open circular disk. So that means if power series in z converges to at a particular point, the same power series will be absolutely convergent in some that open circular disk of radius modulus z naught, of radius modulus z naught, centered at the origin. Similarly, the another theorem statement, diverges at z minus z naught, so it will be divergent for outside the open circular disk, same open circular disk. Let us come to now how to test the powers, the convergence of a power series. We will usually apply ratio test or root test over a power series. We will see examples for that, corresponding examples after this. You can say this is the stepwise logic how to determine the convergence or divergence of a power series. So on a power series, we'll apply ratio test or root test. We have studied in the earlier lecture, and there will correspond an R which is non-zero finite real number, non-zero finite positive real number, non-zero finite positive real number, for which the power series converges absolutely in this open circular disk centered at B of radius R and diverges outside the open circular disk centered at B and of radius R. It may happen that in some cases it may converge absolutely for every z, for every value of z, and there for every value of z radius R becomes infinity and converges at a particular point. So then radius will be zero if it converges at a particular point and diverges elsewhere. Let us see these three kind of examples. Before the examples, this R will be called radius of convergence. Radius of convergence, and Z equals to B will be called center of convergence, and this modulus Z minus B equals to R, modulus Z minus B equals to R will be called circle of convergence. Here the statement might be written wrongly. And here also will be that will be circle of convergence, maybe open or closed or half open or half closed depending on the given series. Now let us see examples. From the examples it will be very much clear, I think. A geometric series is given. This series can be written in this form: minus z of z, negative of z minus 2 whole divided by 2 whole to the power n. So of this series corresponding to n equals to 0, first term is 1, and ratio, common ratio is this R. So we have seen that corresponding to a geometric series, corresponding to a geometric progression, first of all, if geometric progression has n number of terms, so its sum become first term into a fraction. In the numerator it remains 1 minus r to the power n, r is the common ratio. In the denominator 1 minus r. So if modulus r is less than 1 means r is a proper fraction. Proper fraction are those fractions of which denominator is greater than the numerator. Numerator is smaller, denominator is greater. For those fractions are called proper fractions. For proper fractions, if we talk about r to the power n, when r modulus r is less than 1, r to the power n tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. I leave it to you to check whether it is true or not. It will be true. So I was saying that of a geometric progression of which n number of terms are there, first term is a and common ratio is r, so sum will be a into 1 minus r to the power n divided by 1 minus r. So as r to the power n tends to 0 when modulus r is less than 1 as n tends to infinity. The sum of this series becomes this, a into 1 by 1 minus r. So this series has sum, this is convergent to this sum, and therefore we can, putting this value, putting the expression r of r, we can get 2 by z. When r modulus r is less than 1, so modulus r is this, so from this modulus r is less than 1 we get this. So now we are having this conclusion that this series is having this sum 2 by z when modulus z minus 2 is less than 2. So 2 is the center of convergence, B here. 2 here, also 2 is R, which is the radius of convergence. And modulus z minus 2 equals to 2 is the circle of convergence. So inside this open circular disk, this series convergent is absolutely convergent by ratio test, or by ratio test. You can find it by ratio test also. So absolutely convergence, and also thereby convergent in this open circular disk, and outside this open circular disk it is divergent. Next, let us come to next example. This z to the power n by 1 by factorial n. So an is here 1 by factorial n, and z minus 0 whole to the power n, where b is 0. So applying ratio test over this, this is the nth term. So applying ratio test over this, we'll get this. Limit n tends to infinity modulus z by n plus 1, which is always 0, and of course which is less than 1. So according to ratio test, this series is absolutely convergent everywhere in the complex plane for all z belongs to C, everywhere in the complex plane, and therefore convergent also. So therefore radius of convergence r equals to infinity, that must be, because it is convergent everywhere in the complex plane. Let us come to the next example. So it is divergent nowhere, it is convergent everywhere. Third example, factorial n into z to the power n. So here also apply ratio test, we are getting at this limit n tends to infinity n plus 1 into modulus z. This will be equals to 0 at z equals to 0 only. This limit will be 0 at z equals to 0 only. Elsewhere, this is always infinity. So this limit is 0, means less than 1, means this series this limit is 0 at z equals to 0 only, which is less than 1. So we can say that this series is absolutely convergent at z equals to 0 only, elsewhere it is divergent. So here we can see, except z equals to 0, this series diverges. And radius of convergence is r equals to 0, because it is divergent at only one singular point, which is z equals to 0. Thank you. There are two theorems, first related to power series. term by term differentiation theorem and term by term integration theorem. So whenever a power series is convergent absolutely, or absolutely convergent means convergence in some open circular disk z minus modulus z minus b less than r for some positive r, finite positive r, will have certainly a sum which is a function, because z variable is present here in the series, power series. So sum will be no more a complex constant, it will be a complex function because of the z variable. So we can write like this: sum function will be equals to the series in this region, in this open circular disk. And then such a sum function f of z is analytic. This is a theorem, established theorem. We will read this theorem without proof. So if a function is analytic, it has derivatives of all orders inside the circle of convergence. This circle of convergence, modulus z minus b equals to r, circle of convergence. And consequently we'll have d by dz means f dash z equals to term by term differentiation. So if we do term by term differentiation, it will be like d by dz and d by dz will be outside, operated on both sides, outside of the function. So d by dz operated on f of z, which is f dash z, and here d by dz, it will interchange. D by dz and summation will be like interchanging, will come inside of this, will come inside of this sequence of functions, and we'll take the derivatives as usual. So derivative of this z minus b whole to the power n is n into z minus b to the power n minus 1. Correspondingly, d by dz of f dash z means f double dash z is this. So remember here it is n minus 1, so here it will be starting from n equals to 1, corresponding to n, here it is starting from n equals to 0, corresponding to n minus 1, here it is start will n equals to 1, corresponding to n equals to n minus 2, here it will start from n equals to 2. Otherwise we will get invalid series terms. So each of these derived series converges at every interior point, everywhere inside the circular disk of convergence. Let us take an example. Summation z to the power n, simple example. This is a geometric series with the first term, correspond to n equals to 0, z to the power 0, which is 1, and common ratio is r equals to z. So we have seen that this geometric series, if it is convergent, where r modulus r is less than 1, or modulus z is less than 1, for which the sum is a by 1 minus r, so which is this. So this series, power series, has this sum. It can be written like this: 1 by 1 minus z equals to summation z to the power n when modulus z less than 1. So if we take term by term differentiation, f dash z will be 1 minus 1 by z whole square, or we can write like this: n into z to the power n minus 1, z to the power n derivative is n into z to the power n minus 1. Corresponding derivatives, like 1 by 1 minus z whole square will have derivative this, and n into z to the power n minus 1 will have this derivative, where this will start index from n equals to 2 to infinity. So term by term differentiation is valid for power series only, not for any other kind of series. And now term by term integration. So again, if a series, power series, is convergent absolutely or convergent, absolutely convergence means convergence in a certain open circular disk, then it has sum f of z, then it can be integrated. F of integration f of z dz will be integrated, like integral operator will be operated here, it will be interchanging with the summation. So integration of this, n is a constant, so over z minus b whole to the power n integration will be applied. So integration of z minus b whole to the power n is this plus a constant. It will be a complex constant for this region. Let us see an example. So this is a series given, or explicitly terms are like this. We can apply ratio test to investigate the series nature, and we are obtaining at this result. Modulus z square. So now modulus z square may be greater than 1, equals to 1 and less than 1. Three probabilities are there. So we know by ratio test that when the limit is less than 1 or mod z less than 1, mod z square less than 1 or mod z less than 1, then the series absolutely converges. And then it will have a sum function. So let us write f of z. This is unknown. F of z is unknown. So f of z we have to find out, which is the sum of the series. So for mod z less than 1. So let us integrate this relation in order to find out this f of z. So first of all, let us differentiate term by term. And then let us integrate. So f dash z, correspondingly it will be minus 1 whole to the power n z to the power 2 to the 2, z to the power 2n minus 2. Here it will come. So minus 1 whole to the power n minus 1, minus 1 whole to the power n minus 1 z to the power 2n minus 2 can be rewritten as, think about it, minus or negative z square whole to the power n minus 1. I'm repeating again, summation n equals to 1 to infinity, it can be rewritten as negative z square whole to the power n minus 1. So the first term of the series corresponding to n equals to 1 is 1, and common ratio is minus z square. So as per the formula, this f dash z will be this, or this series will have sum as a by 1 minus r. So we are getting this. So f dash z, we are getting this. Let us integrate for this region. Let us integrate now. F of z equals to integration of this plus c. This c is a complex constant. So we will get tan inverse z plus c. So let us put now z equals to 0 on both sides. On the right hand side, putting z equals to 0, tan inverse 0 is 0. So we are getting only c. On the left hand side, f of z equals to 0, putting z equals to 0, f of 0 we are getting. What is f of 0? F of 0 is 0, absolutely 0. F of 0 is 0. See, this series is, this entire thing is 0, as z to the power 2n minus 1 is there. So summation n equals to 1 to infinity 0, which is a convergent series, will give the value 0. So this f of 0 is 0, and then we are getting c equals to 0. So f of z equals to tan inverse z for this range. Thank you.